Come and join me in my travels to the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them, there's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, oh golly double G, just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. Golly, double gosh! Did you hear that thunder? It's enough to bounce a dragon right out of bed. But even when sounds are loud, like thunder, I like the way they sound. Without sound, the world would be such a quiet place. There'd be no music, no laughter. Imagine! Listen to the sounds all around you. What do you hear?
The next word down, what is that? Jace?
Chalk on the board. The pages of a book.
Now look at the next column, boys and girls, and look at the very top. Today we're going to do something
different. Your teacher's voice.
We're going to write them down, and if you look at a 97, there's a box.
And how about the sounds outside?
And that box is very special because it's kind of like a puzzle.
Cinderella dressed in yellow went upstairs to kiss the bell. Made a mistake and kissed the snake. How many doctors did it take? 10, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
Once upon a time, Jenny walked to a forest filled with magic.
Oh, here's one of my favorite sounds. Reading stories out loud. That reminds me, I need volunteers to take a sensational journey. Who likes to listen and play with words? And who is simply C-R-A-Z-Y crazy about sounds?
Wow, look at this place!
It sure is amazing! But Peter, where are we?
Why, this is Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place that I dreamed up. Full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime. Hear that? Frogs croaking. Birds chirping. Screeching brakes.
Lion roaring.
Church bells ringing. Wow! Hear those sounds? Quick, close your eyes. What do you hear?
I hear a broom sweeping.
And you, Jessica?
And I hear birds singing.
Boy, you two are sensational.
Figgy, this is fun. Let's keep going.
Hold on tight. We're going to the place deep inside our minds where anything is possible and every sound means adventure. Just listen to the magic words. Watch carefully, listen closely, see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic of your mind, you can be wherever you want to be. Listen to the sounds all around you.
We're at my house. And I hear someone coming. Someone's ringing the doorbell. It's Josh, my next door neighbor. He found my kitten, Lulabelle. She's purring because she's happy to be home.
Oh, hi, Josh.
Hi, I found Lulabelle.
Oh, thank you for bringing her home.
Uh-oh. Now I hear my baby brother crying.
Oh, that's my baby. I gotta go.
Okay, bye.
Bye, thanks.
You're welcome.
Oh, listen to that baby. I've got an idea. Let's pretend we're babies and listen to the sounds around us.
How's that? Is that better?
Yeah.
You want to play? You want to play?
Oh, the sounds are so soft. They're making me sleepy.
Oh. Babies feel how different sounds sound. When sounds are loud, I bet they feel scared.
Mama loves you. 99.
When sounds are soft,
night, Andrew.
I think babies feel safe and loved.
You know, sounds make me have feelings too. Like when I hear the telephone ring. You know, it makes me happy because it might be my friend calling me to play. Hey, how you doing? I'm sorry, I can't play with you right now. I'm in Figonia. Okay, bye.
It makes me sad. It's probably my mom telling me to come home for dinner. Hi, Mom. Can I stay just a little longer? Gee, thanks.
You know, it's neat because we both heard the same sounds but each had different feelings.
Now you're talking. That's what makes sound such an adventure. Now that you know how sound makes you feel, let's feel sound. Bum! Bum! Oh, I love that beat, and I love sound journeys. What do you feel when you bang it?
Tickles.
Ooh, what you are feeling are sound vibrations. Want to see how it looks?
You can't see sound.
Oh, but Peter, sound journeys are more than sensational. They're also vibrational. Watch these sound waves move. That's why I want to go even farther, into the garden of imagination, to a place where words bloom.
Words bloom? How?
It starts with a balloon. That's it. Blow that balloon up as big as it can go. Then... You get the idea. Now, what sound did you hear?
Pop.
You've made a real word just by saying a sound. Pop! Pop.
Hey, Figgy, pop. I like this. Let's do some more.
Okay, ready, steady, go!
Chirp! Toot. Tick. Splash.
Chirp, toot, tick, splash. Now you've got the beat. It starts in your hands, then it moves to your feet.
Chirp, toot, tick, splash. Now you've got the beat. It starts in your hands and moves to your feet.
Save your clapping and we'll use it to make rhythm. Take one hand, then meet it with the other. Whee! It's so simple, you can do it with your brother. Come on now, let's go faster. The rhythm that you beat makes me want to leave my seat and dance and move and play around. You started with the clap, now you made a happy sound. That's rhythm. That's rhythm.
She's just a snake. How many doctors did it take? The nurse called the lady.
out or travel even further, just use your mind. In the garden of imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. We've made words bloom and rhythms grow, and the seeds of adventure we've begun to sow. Just add your five senses. Hurry now, make haste. Get ready to see, feel, smell, hear, and taste. Then repeat the magic words after me.
Watch carefully, listen closely, see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, I can be whatever I want to be.
Whoa, I'm moving so fast, I can hardly catch my breath. I feel cold. Everything is so open. I see buildings rushing by, faster and faster. Peter, I smell gasoline. And wait, in the distance I smell smoke. And there is the loudest noise. It's so loud I can barely think. Wait a minute, it's coming from me. I'm a siren on a fire truck, and I'm going to a fire.
And I'm the horn. I'm warning everyone to get out of the way.
Boy, I was scared when I heard how loud I sounded. But now I know I'm helping save people.
Hold on, we need to drive on the wrong side of the street again. Moving in and out of the traffic, I better scream a warning first.
Ooh, the firefighter finally turned you off. All that work made me hungry. Let's all have a BLT. That's an old family specialty of mine. Buttercups and lilacs on toast.
Figment, being a sound was incredible. I wish I could do it all the time.
Just use your imagination.
I wish I could roar like a lion.
Now me, I want to sound like a foghorn on a dark, windy night. Figgy, that was great. We can use our imaginations to travel anywhere in our minds.
And the whole world will bloom for you. I'm Figment. I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I think, but that's me. In my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. Oh, what am I gonna do? Boy, am I glad you're out there. I've got a big problem, and only you can help me. Any volunteers? Let me see. You have to love to play with words and have a W-I-L-D wild imagination. Hey there, Beth and Danny.
Wow, look at this place. Where are we?
Why, this is Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place that I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
What a neat place, Figment. But you said you needed our help. What's the matter?
Oh, a terrible thing has happened in the land of Alpha Cadelpha. The new ruler, King Dreary, doesn't believe in make-believe. He's banned all imaginary flyers from his kingdom, like witches, fairies, ghosts, and even me. Imagine, without make-believe, the land of Alpha Cadelpha will have no color, and it won't be fun anymore. So we have to help.
But what can we do?
Well, here's my plan. Both of you are going to help me talk to all the real flyers who live in the land of Alpha Cadelpha.
What are we going to tell them?
We'll ask them to stay out of the sky until King Dreary lets all of their imaginary flyer friends back into his kingdom.
Okay, sounds great.
So come over to my magic cloud. There's no time to lose, and let's put the plan into action.
So how do we start?
We'll just begin at the beginning. That's where every great dragon plan starts. Let's list the names of everything we can think of that flies.
Come on, you're kidding. There are tons of things that fly.
Dragons never kid. We leave that up to goats. Anyway, there are a lot of kids, oops, I mean children, right out there who can help us name all the things that fly. Everybody ready? Steady? Go!
Well, there are doves.
Bluebirds that whistle and chirp.
And owls that mostly fly at night.
Ooh, my favorite. Eagles. Boy, can they fly high.
So can a jumbo jet. A whirling helicopter. And a rocket.
You can see the whole Earth from a spaceship.
Beth! Beth! Come back to Earth! The make-believe flyers are counting on us! And we still have lots of flyers to name.
Like insects.
Like butterflies.
Annoying ones like flies.
And don't forget animals that fly, like squirrels.
Figment, are you sure? Squirrels that can fly?
Honest, Danny. Some squirrels can fly because they have extra folds of skin that let them G-L-I-D-E, glide through the air.
That's neat.
Figment, at this rate, it'll take forever to name all the real flyers.
No, it won't. Watch this.
Whoa! That does it. I guess we're done.
Whoa, Danny. We're still in the middle. And it's a muddle. Aha! Let's straighten out this mess of names by dividing these flyers into groups.
Okay. But what should we call our groups?
I don't know. But I bet our friends can help. Anybody out there have a guess? What should we call our groups of flyers?
Living flyers.
Green flyers.
Big flyers.
See, I told you they have lots of good answers. Let's pick two.
How about people made flyers and living flyers?
Great. Well, we've got our two groups. Now, let's put living flyers in this column here, and people made flyers there. Then ready, steady, go!
Kid-made flyers.
Like paper airplanes.
And bubbles.
That does it, right, Figgy? Now we're ready for the next part of your plan to save Alpha Cadalpha.
Let me see. It seems to me there's still something missing.
Really?
The final column I have in mind is well in order, I think you'll find. Fairies, flying elephants, flying horses, Peter Pan, magic carpets, dragons, witches, goblins, and ghosts.
All right!
Fairies! Flying elephants! Flying horses.
Even kids.
Kids? You mean like us?
You bet. Now, Danny, your job is to go tell our plan to the people-made flyers, and Beth, you visit the living flyers.
Oh, Figment, I do want to help the imaginary flyers, but I don't know how to fly.
I'm talking about a special kind of flying. The kind you can do in your mind. Use your imagination. Rely on your five senses. Think of something that flies, then imagine how it would taste, smell, feel, look, and sound to be that thing flying around. The thing to remember about flying is that it's just like a story. It has a beginning, a middle, and an end. The beginning, you take off. The middle, you fly. The end, you land. It's easy. Close your eyes, Danny, and repeat the magic words after me.
Watch carefully, listen closely. See what you can see. With the magic of words and the power in your mind, I can be whatever I want to be. Figment, Beth, my engine is on, and I hear a brrrring noise. I'm shaking a little, and it makes me feel all warm inside. I smell like grease and gasoline. Oh, I'm moving, rolling down the runway.
And that's only the beginning, Danny.
Whoa, I'm going faster and faster. I'm off the ground, up in the air. What if the air doesn't hold me? Figment, save me!
Pull up, Danny. You can do it. Use your mind and fly. Whee! That's it!
I did it, Figment. I'm flying. Up in the clouds. They look like cotton candy. I feel like I can reach out and touch them. It's so quiet up here. The only sound I hear is my motor. And it's beautiful.
Now me. I want to fly like an eagle.
You can do it! Whee! Just use your imagination to see, feel, hear, smell, and taste how you think it feels for an eagle to fly.
Know the magic words by heart. Watch carefully. Listen closely. See what you can see. With the power of words and the magic in my mind, I can be whatever I want to be. I'm here, sitting in my nest. But I hear other birds calling. So I stretch out my wings, and I jump into the wind.
Oh, what a graceful beginning.
I'm flying, Figment. It's incredible. I can ride the wind to go up or down. I can soar. Or stay in one place just by how I move my wings.
Oh, look at the cliffs down there. And the water is so beautiful. Ooh, the wind feels so good on my feathers.
That's it, that's it. You both got it. You're in the middle of flying, which brings us to the end of our plan. Danny, it's up to you to fly off and ask all the people-made flyers to stay out of the sky until King Dreary changes his mind.
And I'll talk to all the living flyers, Figment.
Figment, I did it! I talked to all the people-made flyers, and they said they'd stay out of the sky until King Dreary lets the imaginary flyers back in the Alpha Cadalpha.
And same for the living flyers.
Okay, okay, I give up. I need my real flyers. And to be honest, I missed the imaginary flyers. What's a world without color?
Let's change his name from Dreary to Deary.
Figment, I'd like to go back to Alpha Cadalpha and take all our friends.
How do we get there again?
Just use your imagination and let your thoughts fly. To fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. Come and join me in my travels to the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't fear. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me.
If you're just gonna sit there staring into space, we'll never get this story finished.
I'm not just staring into space. We're supposed to write a story about dragons, right? Well, I was just daydreaming about talking to a dragon. I wonder if dragons daydream.
You were gonna ask a dragon if he dreams? Jeremy, get real. You can't talk to dragons.
Hi, Jeremy. Hi, Emma. I overheard you wondering if dragons dream. I come from a long line of dragons who dream. It's a family specialty.
Emma, that's the dragon I was about to talk to.
I can't believe it. You're the dragon talking to me.
I must be dreaming.
Who are you? And where are we?
Why, this is Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place that I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
Thanks. We have to go home and write a story for school. We don't have time to talk to dragons.
But Emma, maybe Figment can help us with the story. He is a dragon, you know.
Jeremy!
We better make this good, Figment.
Good? You're talking to a bona fide authority on dragons. This is going to be G-R-E-A-T. Great. Okay, tell me what you've done with your story so far. Where did you start?
Well, we started by going to the library, like yours here, Figment, but bigger.
Then we took out books about dragons.
We read them.
Then we started to write.
But nothing.
That's when I said we should sit and write till something good came. But Jeremy started imagining dragons, and here we are.
That's perfect.
But Figment, I just told you, we couldn't think of a story.
That's because stories begin here, in the imagination. And you two just popped in a minute ago. Good ideas sometimes take time.
But Figment, our story's due in the morning.
No problem. Then ready, steady, go!
Wait a minute, go where?
To look at stories that started in someone's imagination.
Uh-oh, Figment. I'll never be able to write a story. I don't think I have an imagination.
Sure you do. We all create pictures in our minds.
Well, I guess. But sometimes the pictures in my mind are scary. Like when I have nightmares.
Ooh, nightmares. I have those too. We all do sometimes. So, I have this little trick. I think nightmare. Night reminds me that I was sleeping, and mare, that's a horse. Put the two together, and it means I was asleep, having a dream that ran wild. Then when I wake up, I'm not afraid, because I know it wasn't real.
Wow, that's a great idea, Figment. I'll try it.
Thanks, but do you know what my favorite kind of dreams are? Daydreams. You know, the think of new things and ideas kind of dreams. For them, you have to be W-I-D-E, wide awake. Ready to try?
Sure.
Well, I guess.
Close your eyes. Watch carefully. Listen closely. See what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic of your mind, you can be wherever you want to be.
I'm thinking about everything getting big. Really big. I mean huge. I mean really huge. Gigantic.
Figgy, I can't do it.
Keep trying. As Grandpa Figonius used to say to me, if at first you don't succeed, try again.
Wow! I can do it! I'm imagining! It's great, Figma, it's great! I can see two mice. They're on the back of a big white bird that's soaring through the sky.
Thank you. That's it, Emma. Now, just imagine what you'd like to be.
You mean I can become whatever I want just by imagining it?
Sure. Take me. Whenever I'm in a Saskatoonifras kind of mood, I just imagine myself as one.
Saskatoona?
Saskatoonifras.
Yeah, I want to be a Saskafruity-tooty too, just like you, Figment.
Okay, give it a try.
Figment, nothing happened.
I told you dreaming's hard.
Go to the imagination board and prepare to check dream system. Was your imagination ready?
Check.
Did you let your mind go?
I think so.
Were you dreaming your own dream?
Uh-oh. I guess I was dreaming your dream. It seems so neat to be a Saskatoonifras. I knew that.
That's the problem. You have to dream your own dream, right from your heart.
Well, Figment, my dream's kind of silly.
Impossible. If it matters to you, it's important.
Okay, I'll try. Let's see. Well, my dream. I see myself zooming through stars and planets into outer space. I'm a comet flying through the universe. It's dark out here, but I'm very bright. I'm burning up, but I'm still freezing. I feel like ice.
Oh, isn't the imagination wonderful?
Now I see Earth. It's so beautiful. It looks so quiet and peaceful. I want to stay here forever. Oh, I'm back. I loved it up there, Figment. I want to go back. There's no way I can zoom around outer space except in my mind.
Take it from a dragon who dreams. Nothing is impossible.
Then I can go back for real? How?
If we use our brains, I bet we can come up with a storm of ideas. A real brainstorm.
If I ran as fast as I could, maybe I could jump right off the Earth.
We could blast drive a cannon.
Or I could hold on to a big bunch of balloons and float away.
We could fly to a cloud, and I could catapult you off my tail.
I don't know, Figment. We may need something with a little more power to get into outer space. Like a jet. Or a rocket, that's it. We need a rocket.
That won't work, Emma. Where are we gonna find a rocket? You can't just go out and buy one or find one parked in your garage.
But Jeremy, you can be an astronaut. They use rockets. They even walk in space.
But becoming an astronaut will take years. I'll never get to outer space.
What? Giving up on your dream, Jeremy?
But how can I make it happen?
Dreams don't always come true right away. But if you have a dream and you believe in it, you'll find a way to make it happen.
Emma, I'm going to the moon.
Vicky, what about me? I want to be a wizard, like Merlin. Wizards can do anything.
But I feel like I'll never get to be one. You know what a crummy dreamer I am.
Emma, everyone can be a good dreamer. You love to read and write and study, just like Merlin, so you're already halfway there. All you need to do now is let your mind go and picture yourself as a wizard. Just close your eyes and say the magic words with me.
Watch closely, listen carefully. See what you can see.
Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can be whatever you want to be.
I hear sounds of instruments. And I'm holding a baton. When I put it down, there's music. And when I bring it back up, there's more music. I'm an orchestra conductor.
That's a wizard of sound.
Now I'm holding a paintbrush, and I smell paint. I can paint colors and shapes,
anything I want. Beautiful pictures. I'm an artist, Figment.
A wizard of shapes, lines, and colors.
My head is so full of numbers. I'm inventing all kinds of concoctions. I mix this with that, and it turns into something completely different. I'm a chemist.
A wizard of science.
Now I'm a writer, a wizard of words.
Emma, stop daydreaming. We have to finish this story.
How's this? Once in a dream, we traveled to a place called Figonia.
Wait, let's call it Dragonsville or Dragonopolis.
Yeah, Dragonopolis, okay. Once in a dream, we traveled to a place called Dragonopolis, where we met a little purple dragon, only let's make him yellow.
Yeah.
With orange polka dots. Named Figment.
That's great. How about, he knew a lot about dragons, being one himself. But what we really wanted to know most of all was,
Do dragons dream?
I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment. I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment. I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. Like Figment. Come and join me in my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. Like Figment, that's me. Shh! I'm looking for elephants. Wildebeest. Giraffes. And zebras. But no elephants here. Golly gee! Found a whole herd! Hooray for me! My idea of a shower. Yoo-hoo! Mr. Elephant, I'm hot too. Spray some water over here. This is the best. This is the greatest. Learning about elephants and other animals. Boy, I have to share this. Volunteers. That's what I need. Yoo-hoo! Anybody out there like me? What? No purple dragons out there? I mean, who likes to read like I do? Who is W-I-L-D, wild about words? Can't stop imagining. Hey there, Matt and Lisa. Come on and join me.
Wow,
what is this place?
Why, this is Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place that I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime. But right now, we have somewhere special to go. So hurry up and change.
Where are we going?
On a safari, to where elephants live. In deepest Africa.
What's a safari?
A safari is a trip where you learn about animals. But this isn't just any trip. This is an imagination safari, and we're going to travel in our minds. It starts with the magic words. Watch carefully, listen closely, see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic of your mind, you can be wherever you want to be. Use your imagination. Paint pictures with it.
Ooh, now I see something. It looks like a circle, but it's just a blob.
Well, that's a good start. Now use the power of words to describe an elephant.
Well, it's really big, as big as a truck.
And it has wrinkles like an old clothes. No, more like the wrinkles on raisins.
And it's gray like a thundercloud.
And it has two ears like huge giant fans. No, not those kind. The kind that go whoosh, whoosh. That's it.
And a long trunk like a straw. No, more like a horn.
Don't forget the tail.
Ooh. Hey, Figgy, look at the elephant we made.
It's great what you can create with words. Which gives me an idea. Now that you've created the outside of an elephant, let's go inside and see how it feels to be an elephant.
I don't know. That elephant's awfully big.
No, no. We're not really going inside an elephant. This is an imagination safari. We'll just listen to him talk.
Figment, you're so silly. Animals don't talk.
Well, not in our language, but I bet you can understand them. Why, just the other day, I was talking to my friend the giraffe.
Figgy, show us.
Just remember the magic words. Watch carefully. Listen closely. What do you think he's saying?
I'm angry because I didn't have enough breakfast, so you better stay out of my way.
So far, so good. But now, just try and guess how these other animals are feeling.
They're saying, feed me, feed me.
That gorilla looks like he's saying, I'm the boss around here.
Hey kids, come over to my book nook and take a look into your favorite storybooks. You'll find lots of pictures of animals in there. Then, when you know what these animals are feeling, yell it out.
Okay, Figment, I'm ready.
Oh, he looks like he's feeling so sad because nobody likes him.
Oh, Lisa, you're good at this. Now it's your turn, Matt.
Let me see. Lady and the Tramp want everyone to see their cute family. They feel proud.
I know why I can't stump you two. You've been talking to animals all your lives.
We have?
You bet. How about your cat, Samantha?
Oh, you're right. When I pet her, she purrs, and then I know she's happy.
It's the same with my dog, Flash.
That's right, Matt. When you pet him, you make him happy. And do you know what will make me happy? Looking at more animals. Now, what do you think Tigger and Roo are feeling?
Excited. I can tell because they're jumping up and down like little kids.
It's the ugly duckling again. But now he's happy because he's finally found some friends.
I just love happy endings. Don't you?
Okay, Figment, now you try. We'll show you some animals and you try to tell us what you think they're feeling. Let them roll, Matt.
Well, I guess fair is fair.
Well, Figment, we're waiting.
I'm thinking. Let me see. They all felt the same thing, but showed it differently. I know, but I'm not telling. Not unless all of you out there yell it out with me. What are all these animals feeling? Ready? Go!
They're scared!
Great job!
Ready for another one? Watch this.
That's my favorite feeling because you feel happy just being with someone special.
That's the way we feel about you, Figgy.
Gee, Lisa. They're feeling love. Guess it's a good thing I saved my best surprise for last.
What is it?
Well, up to now we've had to watch closely. Oops, wrong watch. Let's start again. As I was saying, we've had to watch closely and listen carefully to learn how animals feel. But now we'll really use our imaginations and turn each of you into an animal. But I won't tell you which animal. It's up to you to solve the mystery.
But how?
By using your senses. In fact, I call this the sensational part of the safari. You'll have to see, taste, hear, and feel what your animal feels. Okay? Who's first?
Me! Ooh, I feel water all around me, and I'm weightless like astronauts in space. The water tastes salty, so I must be in the ocean. Maybe I'm a fish, because there's hundreds of other beautiful fish swimming around me. I hear a strange calling sound, like a deep squeak. I know that sound. I'm a dolphin. I'm going up to the surface to breathe air and play.
Great job, Lisa.
Guess it's my turn. I hear cowbells in the distance and flies buzzing around my head. I have metal shoes that make a clop-clop sound when I walk. I'm a horse!
Rachel! See how easy it is? Now tell us, how does it feel to be a horse?
It feels great. My mouth is getting dry, though. I sure wish I had some water. The countryside is whizzing by me, and I can feel the sweat on my back. I feel very free. I hear my hoofbeats getting louder and louder. My heart's pounding. Oh no! Figment, help!
Jump, Matt!
I did it, Figment! I did it! Lisa, did you see me? I was scared, but I did it anyway. I feel so happy and hungry. All that galloping around, I could eat a horse. Oops, I guess I'll settle for hay and oats.
Pretty neat, huh? But remember, we came on the safari to find out how an elephant feels. What do you say we try that now? You two ready?
Yes, we even know the magic words.
Watch carefully, listen closely, see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can be whatever you want to be.
Thank you.
Well, what do you feel?
I feel powerful. Look how everything shakes as we walk. Even lions stay out of our way.
I feel big. Too big. Whoop! I looked down just in time. I almost stepped on Lisa.
We all watch out for each other. Traveling in a herd, I can hide in between the bigger elephant's legs. Then nothing can hurt me. I feel safe.
I feel hungry all the time. Traveling here and there, always looking for food. I can't believe how many leaves I've eaten this morning, and I still feel my stomach grumbling. What do you say we go back to being ourselves and dig into good old dragon food? Peanut butter and jelly sandwiches.
Wow, that was neat. I can't wait till our next safari.
I'm already packed.
But that's the magic. You don't have to wait for me. Anytime you want to be something different or go somewhere else, just imagine yourself there. Remember, watch carefully, listen closely, and see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind,
you can be whatever you want to be.
To fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. Come and join me in my travels to the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. I've always thought of myself as something of a detective. Solving mysteries, hunting down clues, finding missing things. But now, I have a case that's too big even for me. Let me tell you how it all began. I was sitting around minding my own business. In fact, I was looking for business. All at once, a letter appeared. In fact, several letters and a dot. Those troublesome Tweedles have overrun my place. Figment, come help me. Yours truly. I wanted to help, but who wrote the letter? I needed some letter experts fast.
Yoo-hoo!
Is there anyone out there who is a whiz with words?
Wow, I don't think we're in Kansas anymore.
Welcome to Figonia. Home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
Are we going somewhere, Figment?
Over here. Take a look at this.
This place is neat.
Fantastic.
Someone sent me this letter, but they didn't sign their name. These letters and this note were the only things in the envelope.
Those troublesome Tweedles have overrun my place. Figment, come help me. Yours truly.
Hey, it almost sounds like a poem.
Yeah. P C A E S with a dot. Figment, it says your name in this letter, so it must be from someone you know.
Tweedles, Tweedles. I know where I've heard of Tweedles. I read about them in Alice in Wonderland. Do you have it, Figgy?
Gee, golly and double gosh, but of course.
Check it out.
Cool. Open it up.
Wow. Here's the white rabbit.
And there's the carpenter and the walrus.
And the Cheshire Cat.
There they are, Tweedledee and Tweedledum. Hey, maybe the note is from Alice.
Those letters don't spell Alice. There's no letter L.
And there's no I. Now what?
I've got an idea. Maybe if we learn more about Tweedles.
Yeah, it might give us a clue about who sent the letter.
But where can we learn more about Tweedles?
In a book, naturally.
I'll look over here, okay?
Okay, I'll check here.
You have a book about Tweedles?
I have books about everything. I'm C-R-A-Z-Y crazy about reading. Why, just the other day, I was reading the most terrific book about...
It's here. Tons of stuff about Tweedles. Let's see. They live in Wonderland. They love to tell stories.
They don't sound like they'd be that much trouble.
But they drop in on people, uninvited. You travel in large groups. Aunts, uncles, babies, and cousins. They eat whatever they see. Food that would feed 50 people is just a snack to a Tweedle.
We have to figure out who sent that letter and figure it out fast.
Hey, wait a minute. Maybe those letters can give us a clue. Let's try changing them around.
Okay.
This should help.
Yeah. Okay, Figment, see if you can recognize any names.
Ready when you are.
Okay, wait a minute. Let me move this dot out of the way. How about Cap?
Nope.
Or Sap? Or Ape? Or Ace?
Don't know anyone by those names. Try using four letters.
Then how about Cape? Or Case?
Don't sound familiar.
Space, period.
That must be it, because it uses all the letters and rhymes with place. Thanks, Figment.
Don't mention it.
Those troublesome Tweedles
have overrun my place. Figment, come help me. Yours truly, Space.
Do you know anyone named somebody something Space?
No, but maybe Space is listed in the phone book. No Space here.
Okay, let's think. If Space isn't listed in the Figonia phone book, how can we find him, or her, or it?
Well, I once knew someone named Mr. Woods who really did live in the woods. Maybe Space lives in outer space.
Ooh, let's blast off for outer space. Follow me.
Hold it a minute, Figgy. How could we travel through outer space?
Oh, it's no problem. Not with a special Figment way of traveling.
In a flying saucer?
No.
On a magic carpet?
Nope.
On a runaway horse?
Nope. We're taking a train. A train of thought, that is. We'll just use our imaginations. Then even traveling to the moon is no problem. Listen to the magic words. Watch closely, listen carefully, see what you can see. With the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can be wherever you want to be.
Wow, we're on the moon.
Yoo-hoo, astronaut. Have you seen anyone named Space out here?
Space? Space is everywhere.
No, we mean a person named Space.
Never heard of them. Gotta go. Try inner space.
Inner space? I'm not even sure what or where that is.
I'll show you. Inner space is so small, it can only be seen with a powerful microscope.
Whoa, great.
Gee, Figment, do you think this space person could be that tiny?
In the world of imagination, anything is possible.
Figment, who are these guys?
What? You never saw a germ before? No respect for the underworld. What are you doing spying around here anyway?
We're looking for a person named Space.
Yo, Joe! Seen anybody named Space?
No, nobody named Space here.
Oh, gotta go. That's my ride. Whoa!
Wait a minute. Figgy, this isn't working. We need a plan.
Okay, let's see. Now, we know that space could be anywhere, but I don't know. Maybe Tweedles only go certain places.
I've got it! Let's look in the book again and see where Tweedles go.
Okay.
Oh, you'll need my special Tweedle Travels book.
Tweedle Travels book?
Neat.
I wonder what's inside here.
Let's try the city first.
How are we supposed to check these places out?
Why, by using our imaginations, of course.
Excuse me, Mr. Mouse. You get all over the city. Have you seen anyone named Space?
I'm too busy. Have to keep up the pace. Haven't seen anyone here named Space.
Okay, let's try the country.
Look, there's an owl. They're supposed to be wise. Maybe he knows of what's become of space.
Mr. Owl, please, have you seen someone named Space?
Who do you want?
Space!
No. No space here, period.
If he hasn't seen space, I haven't either.
Obviously, but I should think...
Well, I can't stand here lollygagging all day. Got a tight schedule. And they're not here either! No space!
one as Pace. Sally Pace!
Figment! Yo, Figment! 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 Is that you in there, Figment?
Just figured out the letter was from you.
Figment!
Excuse me, but your name is Sally Pace? Like S period Pace?
Why, of course. And there's my note. Ah, over there. Those troublesome Tweedles have overrun my place. Figment, come help me. Yours truly, S. Period Pace. The S stands for Sally. I came to tell you that those troublesome Tweedles have finally left. But not before they drank all my sassafras tea. And ate all my alphabet soup and left my cupboard empty. You are so lucky they don't come around here, Figment. But hide your pea soup just in case. B-Y-E.
I guess that closes the case of the missing space.
Hello, Figgy. What's for lunch?
Come and join me in my travels to the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them, there's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, oh golly double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me. It has to be here. Ancient dragon legend says it's in a trunk.
Figment!
I can't do this alone. I need some help. Oh, what am I going to do? Boy, am I glad you're out there. I've got a big problem, and only you can help me. Any volunteers? Let me see. You have to love to solve mysteries and be W-I-L-D, wild about words.
Todd, look at this place. It's incredible.
That's for sure. But where are we?
Why, you're in Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place that I dreamed up, full of magic, magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
It's great, Figment. But you said you needed our help.
With what, Figment?
Finding treasure. I'm searching for the magical, mystical, ancient Bookus Dragonius. Some say it contains the key to all the world's knowledge.
Wow, we'll be rich.
We'll be famous.
We'll be wise. Everyone will come to us for advice. I can see it now.
But Figment, we don't have the book yet. And we don't even know where to look.
But I do. Legend has it, my Uncle Max buried the book in a trunk. I was sure you meant a tree trunk.
How about this time, Figment?
This has got to be it.
Yeah.
One, two, three.
Wow!
Look at all this stuff.
Look at me.
There's no book here, Figment.
But wait! What's this?
Yippee! Read it and we're on our way to fame, fortune!
You mean wisdom, Figgy.
Figment, it's a poem! It's true worldly wisdom is in a special book, but finding it depends on how closely you will look.
Look? Look where?
Todd, there's more to this poem. It's very important to be sure what you see. Something can look like one thing, but in fact, another be.
Wow, look at that. Water, sea plants, a crab. I got it!
The book must be in the ocean. Maybe, but I think Uncle Max meant that we won't find the clues as easily as we think.
You mean like how that crab made itself look just like a plant?
Sounds like my Uncle Max. He wasn't your typical dragon. He always loved to play with words, just to see if you were listening.
Hey, look! Ready to get started? Then listen to me. You find your next clue if you look in the tea.
Tea? I don't see any teas. A teapot! That's what Uncle Max means. The clue must be in the tea.
There's nothing in here but a bunch of soggy old leaves. If they're the clue, I don't get it. Wait, the clue said the letter T, not T-E-A like the drink.
Like the tea over there!
This must be it! There's nothing here either.
Golly gosh, you guys! It's got to be here! Let's really look and see what we can see.
Look!
The table! It's shaped like the letter T!
We found it!
Uncle Max wasn't kidding when he said we really have to look closely.
Come on, open it! What's it say?
A woman's face is the next clue, but putting her together is completely up to you. Study the shapes, see how they fit, stick to the job, please don't quit.
A woman's face
Putting it together, it's a puzzle. I'm a whiz at puzzles.
Then ready, steady, go!
Look and find the shape that is round. Discover that. And the next clue is...
Is what?
Bound, ground, bound. Okay, everybody, think. What's round?
Round. Shapes that are round.
Round! Whee!
A wheel? How about
plums,
grapefruits, oranges,
pizza,
balloons,
or a ball?
Figgy, I think we're in trouble. All of these things are around, but none of them seem to be clues.
Hey, maybe it's you.
Me?
Well, yeah, your face is sort of round, isn't it?
But I'm not the clue. There has to be more.
Dara, this time you didn't read the fine print. There is more. I'm in outer space, but I'm also in this room. And I'm the guy who was there when the dish ran away with the spoon.
The dish ran away with the spoon! Over here! Hey, diddle diddle, the cat and the fiddle, the cow jumped over the moon.
The moon! Outer space! It's the moon!
That's gotta be it.
All right, good work!
There's only a picture here, Figment.
What?
There's just a drawing of two faces.
Two faces? I don't see any faces. I see vase, right, Figgy?
Two faces.
A vase.
You're both right.
Boy, Uncle Max really meant it when he said we'd really have to look closely.
But I don't see any clue.
Well, maybe we should look for something with two faces and a vase.
How about looking in a dictionary?
Yeah. I see faces. And under V, I see vases. But I don't see two faces and a vase together.
Well, better keep looking.
Hey, you and me,
two faces.
But no vase. I see it. Two faces and a vase.
Uncle Max's portrait, of course.
Hurrah for you three! You found me by looking closely! What's the matter, nephew? You're looking pale and ghostly. I told you, if you really look, it's amazing what you'll see. Now in the clouds, the last clue will be...
The clouds!
Wait, Uncle Max is kidding, right?
Oh, come on, you guys. We can figure this out. Okay, let's see. In
the... Wait, down here, look. A lion. A lion's guarding the book?
Maybe. But what's this mean? The lion's under the rug?
Oh, you're all wet. Washed up. Not even clothes.
L plus fan plus T. What does this mean?
Okay, let's back up.
I think we better start at the beginning.
I can help with that. When you use your imagination, anything is possible.
Even solving this puzzle?
Righto.
How do we begin?
Close your eyes.
Watch carefully.
Listen closely. See what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can see whatever you want to see.
Hey, I see the puzzle in my imagination.
Me too. Okay, in the in.
In the sounds like in the.
In the. Okay, now. Elephant.
Elephant in the elephant.
Nose. Elephant nose.
Nose like a trunk.
The brick is in a car trunk.
No, the trunk of a tree.
I already looked in the tree trunk.
Did you find a rug there? There's a guy looking under a rug.
A trunk rug?
No. Under the rug. And what's this lion? He's saying,
You plus you plus you're. In the trunk rug. No, I mean in the trunk under your nose. In the trunk under my nose?
I've got it!
What trunk under my nose?
Over here!
But we already looked in that old trunk.
Yeah, but maybe we ought to look more closely. Alright, you guys, here it goes. Fame, fortune.
Yippee! What a team!
Ooh, the pages can't be blank. This better be another one of Uncle Max's little jokes.
Keep looking. If this book is as special as Figment says, it has to say something incredible. There! I knew Uncle Max wouldn't let us down.
Get ready. This is it. The point of this story, as you can plainly see, it's in looking and in searching that all the fun will be. Now take heed, my nephew,
here's wisdom from your Uncle Max. Before you say just what you see, look closely at the facts.
I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment. I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment. I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G. Just use the magic in your mind. Like Figment. Come and join me in my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them. There's a world of magic there. when you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't bear. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings. What a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon. Oh, golly, double G, just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me.
Justin, Kim, dinner's almost ready.
Just a sec, Dad. Be right there.
Esmeralda? What kind of a magic kit is this? No wand, no hat. It doesn't even say abracadabra. That's the last time I give you my allowance money.
But it was the only one left. I figured it must be great.
Bop, rop, bitty, bitty, bop.
Dinner's on the table.
Coming, Dad. Try rop, bitty, bop.
Okay. Rop, bitty, bop.
Oh, no. What did I do? I don't know, but I think we're going to be late for dinner.
I never thought our allowance money would get us this far.
No kidding. Where are we?
Why, this is Figonia, home of Figment of the imagination. That's me. It's a special place I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
Hey, it's the dragon on the magic kit.
My magic kit? Where did you find it?
I didn't find it. I bought it at the store.
At the store? I'm not finished working on it yet.
What do you mean?
Oh, those magic words were only one-way words.
Come on.
I don't know how to get you home yet.
Figment! You must have some idea. Your magic goddess here. Try a spell or something. It's dinner time.
Okay, let's see. A spell. Well, just get out my book of prestidigitation.
Your book of what?
My book of magic spells. Try reading some of those.
Abracadabra! Hocus pocus! Shazam, we're home! Please and thank you! Open sesame! It's not working, Figment.
I better get hold of my friend, Merlin.
You mean Merlin like in Merlin, the greatest wizard of all time? That Merlin?
Confound it!
That Merlin.
Hang it all.
Merlin, I need your help.
Yes, yes, Figment. I hear you, but I have other things to do.
But Merlin, Kim and Justin got hold of my magic kit, and poof, here they are, but...
Yes, yes, and you can't get them home. I'm sure the answer is in one of my books. Yes, books contain the magic we need.
But we tried lots of magic words. Abracadabra, hocus pocus. Open sesame?
Oh, come now. Those are your everyday pull-a-rabbit-out-of-a-hat words. You'll need magic of the most extraordinary sort. We have to unlock the power of words, I...
The power of words?
Like putting words together so they rhyme. Then poof, you're home and simply no time.
Whoa! Magic hat! Look, easy enough.
Okay, giraffe. That rhymes with laugh.
That's it. How about umbrella?
Cinderella. Honey. And money. Hey, this is fun. Okay, Merlin, we've collected rhyming words.
Now what?
Now it's time for a get-home spell. Confound it. Make up a rhyme that will serve you well.
Okay, let's see. Giraffe, laugh, umbrella, Cinderella, honey, and money. Let's see. A rhyme that will help us get home. I've got one. Ready?
Yeah.
What we need is Mary Poppins' magic umbrella or fairy godmother. That worked for Cinderella.
Hey, what happened? We're still here.
Rhyming words always... Oops, dash it. Was somebody wearing blue? I see. Well, if someone's wearing blue, you must make up rhymes with opposites. Little, little, big, big, big. Opposites. You know.
Okay, opposites. Hot. So the opposite is cold. How about dirty?
And clean.
What about dry?
Wet.
Now we need to make up a rhyme using opposites and we're home. Let's see. Hot and cold. Dirty, clean. Dry and wet.
I've got one. Maybe if I say wet and its opposite dry, you'll be home in the wink of an eye.
Merlin, what happened?
Oh, confound it, rain. I don't suppose you have a gray and white cat named Esmeralda. You must. When you rhyme with opposites and have a gray and white cat named Esmeralda, it always rains.
So what do we do now?
Keep trying, of course. Figment, we better make this quick. Try rhyming words that sound alike, but are spelled differently, and mean different things, too.
Whoa, Merlin. Rhyme with words that sound alike, but are spelled differently, and mean different things?
That's the idea. Like night and night.
I've got one. How about pear and pear?
A pair of pears.
How about hair and hair? I think I've got one. Let's see.
Listen to this.
A hare can hop. The hair on the head. I hope we get home in time to be fed.
Well, that did it.
Not really. We're still here.
You mean you're invisible? Merlin!
Don't tell me. That always works. Unless, of course, someone's wearing shoes.
Of course we're wearing shoes.
Forgive me. With shoes, it's necessary to use words that mean the same but are spelled differently.
Different words that mean the same thing?
You mean like speak and talk?
Close
and near.
Smart
and intelligent.
Look
and watch.
Watch? Oh, no, I'm terribly late for my appointment with Arthur. Fate and destiny, you know. So long, you three. Good luck.
But Merlin, wait.
It's okay, Justin. Seeing Merlin gave me an idea. We can think like wizards.
Think like Merlin? How?
By watching closely and listening carefully and using our imagination. We'll just use everything we learned about the power of words, shake it all up, and then I just know you'll get home.
Let's see. Magic words, rhymes, opposites, sound-alikes.
If this works, Figment, I'll miss you.
Abracadabra! Hocus pocus! And Shazam! We'll usually get you out of a jam! But getting home from Figonia takes a special touch! From Merlin the Magician, we learned that much! Sound alike! Mean the same! Opposite! Or not! The power of words! We'll get us out of this spot!
Justin, Kim, put that magic kit away and come to dinner.
We did it! Coming, Dad, right this minute! Do you think we'll ever get back to Figonia?
I hope so. I miss Figment already.
What's for dinner? Come and join me in my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them, there's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there's nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, oh golly double G. Just use the magic in your mind. I'm Figment, that's me.
Yummy. Blue potatoes, orange sandwiches, pink cauliflower, all my favorites. But something's missing. Ah, friends, that's what I need. Yoo-hoo! You out there, anybody L-O-V-E, love to eat. And you have to like colors and books and words and adventures.
Wow, look at this place. Where are we?
Why, you're in Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
I love magic.
Magic takes energy, so we'd better eat.
Yeah.
Boy, I feel so hungry, I could eat a...
new potatoes, green milk, orange sandwiches, Figment.
I know. You're sorry we're not having turquoise carrots. Maybe next time.
It's not that, Figgy. Yeah, I mean, I'm sure you're a terrific cook and all. It's just that, well, you know, everything's so... colorful.
And as good as it looks.
I don't know, Figment. The thought of drinking green milk feels kind of, you know, gross.
Oh, so colors make you feel, do they?
Sure, Figment. Colors make me feel all kinds of things.
Oh, I knew you two were perfect. Follow me.
Perfect for what?
Where are you going?
To help King Jerry.
Who's he? Where is he?
Where great characters come to life, in the pages of books. Once upon a time, there was a kind king, King Dreary, who felt so blue, he ordered his whole kingdom painted blue to match his mood. But blue made the people feel sad.
So King Dreary, wanting to be a good king, invited his subjects to help choose the best color for their kingdom.
Yellow, I say, because then we'll have sun all night and all day.
One moment. I'm Farmer McShed, and I insist it has to be red.
As the kingdom's teacher, I agree with the king. Our home should be blue. Blue reminds me of spring.
They argued long into the night, and no one could agree. So weary King Jury decided to turn everything gray.
I know this solution is far from great. Oh, can you decide the color of our fate?
Figgy, that's terrible. What can we do?
Well, you said colors make you feel. Now just add your imagination. That's the best problem solver of all.
Okay, let's try it.
Then ready, steady, go!
Go where, Figment?
To an all-blue world.
Why?
Well, I figure it this way. If we can see how each color makes us feel, we can pick the one that makes us feel great.
Then we can tell King Dreary what color to make his kingdom.
Righto! So, how do you feel about blue?
I don't know, Figment. Blue reminds me of winter, and that makes me feel kind of sad. You know, when everything's cold and icy. I like it. Sometimes it makes me feel really peaceful and quiet. And sometimes it makes me feel excited. Like when I look at the sky at night with all the stars.
Blue makes me feel hungry for a blueberry brownie.
Uh-oh, we're in trouble. Forget about blue. Well, maybe we'll all like red. Wow, an all-red world is weird.
Well, that's how it looks, but how does it make you feel?
Red reminds me of sunset, and that makes me feel warm and happy. To me, red seems like fire, and that feels kind of scary.
Really? Oh, red doesn't feel scary to me. It makes me feel like jumping and whirling and just being crazy. Red makes me feel full of energy.
Well, we don't agree on red, but everyone likes yellow. Not me. Yellow reminds me of lemons, and they make me feel all puckery and sour.
You mean yellow doesn't make you feel sunny and cheerful? Like you're glowing inside?
Sometimes, but sometimes it's just too bright.
Ooh, yellow is the color of a ferocious panther's eyes, and that's frightening.
Oh no, look at all those fillings from just three colors.
Oh.
My favorite's blue. Figment's is red.
Righto!
And you like yellow best. How are we going to help King Drew when we can't find a color we all like?
Hey, look! A rainbow!
Beautiful.
I like all colors together best of all.
Then let's go. There's a world of color waiting to be explored.
You mean like Greenland?
Or the Black Forest?
Not even the Red Sea. We're going to use our minds to travel to the place where anything is possible. The imagination! And we'll throw in a few cents, too.
This trip costs money?
Oops, silly me. Wrong sense. I meant our senses. We'll see, hear, taste, touch, and smell what it's like to be colorful. Okay, ready, steady, go!
But how do we get there, Figment?
Just close your eyes and listen to the magic words. Watch carefully, listen closely, see what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can be whatever you want to be.
Figment, what am I?
Oh, that's the fun. Use your senses to figure out what you are.
I don't know what I am, but I feel colors raining down.
My colors look all blurry, but wait, I feel myself beginning to move.
I'm moving too, but my colors are mixing and shooting into patterns.
You should see my patterns. They're beautiful. Look, I keep changing.
You're changing. I'm spinning faster and faster. So fast I'm dizzy, and I can hardly see my colors. I feel the air rushing over me, and I can hear a motor.
I hear little click-clacking sounds, and you should see the shapes I can make, just like a kaleidoscope. That's it. That's what I am.
Whoa, I'm finally slowing down. I'm a painting.
That was great, Figment.
We should tell King Dreary. The more colors there are, lots of colors, all the colors, the more fun it is.
That's it. What a team.
King Dreary.
Yes?
Your Majesty? Your Highness, sir. Good King Dreary. Figment's Scott and I, after a lot of thought, well, we came to the conclusion that
your kingdom should be all colors.
Let me see. On the advice of experts, I command all colors are welcome in this land.
He liked our idea.
Well, we were pretty terrific. Tell you what else is terrific? My appetite. Thinking makes me hungry. Pass me a blue potato, please, and take one for yourself.
Figment. I know we just learned how great all colors are. But no blue potatoes, please.
Pink cauliflower?
No thanks, but I'd love an orange sandwich.
Me too.
Do-do-do-do-do. Come and join me in my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them, there's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, oh golly double G. Just use the magic in your mind, like Figment, that's me. In my travels through the pathways of the mind. When you use imagination, there's no telling what you'll find. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm a master of illusion, doing things that you can't see. When I smell a pink petunia, it turns into a bee. I open books and jump into them, there's a world of magic there. When you add your own five senses, there is nothing you can't dare. Ah, I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, I read and learn and play. Sounding sounds, feeling feelings, what a way to fill a day. I'm Figment, I'm a dragon, oh golly double G. Just use the magic in your mind, like Figment, that's me. Dinosaurs would make a good story, but they're not quite what I'm looking for. The Wild West. Great tall tales, but not this time. No, too space age. I want a good old-fashioned story. Yoo-hoo! You out there, I have a problem and only you can help. But you have to L-O-V-E, love books and stories and words and adventures.
Wow.
Where are we?
Over here. You're in Figonia, home of Figment of the Imagination. That's me. It's a special place I dreamed up, full of magic. Magic of the mind. Magic that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
Magic of the mind? Go anywhere, anytime? Figment, are we going somewhere? We just got here.
Well, we may need to do a little time traveling.
What?
It's like this. Every year, at this time, I go to the Tall Tale Telltale.
The what?
You know, where all the best storytellers come to tell each other stories. Everybody who is anybody is there. Jiminy Cricket. Wendy. Why, last year, Paul Bunyan won first prize for telling the tallest tale. And this year, I hope I'll be a winner. But I'll need a super duper de-looper greater than great kind of story. A real adventure.
But what does all that have to do with flying through time?
I figure if we all search together through time, we'll find a terrific idea.
And then we could use it to make a great story.
I don't know. Well, it all sounds great, except for the flying part. People can't fly through time.
Nick!
Wow. Maybe they can.
Of course you can. With the power of words and the magic in your mind, anything is possible. Besides, you two have been traveling through time all your lives.
We have?
Gee, golly, and double gosh, of course. Every time you open the pages of a book.
Wow, neat. A Christmas Carol is one of my favorite stories. Look, we're in Old England.
Looks to me to be about the 1800s.
Wow, you're right. Books can take us anywhere.
Well, if time traveling is that easy, maybe we can solve your problem. We'll just keep looking through books until we find the best story ever.
Well, that's a great idea. But there's one tiny little itsy-bitsy teeny-weeny catch. Remember, it has to be a brand new story, the kind you make up.
Well, I've always liked pirate stories. How about then? Wow!
That's it! I can see it already. Once upon a time, about 200 years ago, there was a pirate named, Fledibus.
Wow, Jesse, I told you had a great imagination.
Avast, ye swabs. I am a pirate. My name is Fledibus. I lived 200 years ago.
Hey, he looks like a pirate, but he doesn't sound like one. It's like he's from the future instead of the past.
And I thought we were off to such a flying start. Prepare to check the storytelling system. Pick the subject.
Check, pirates.
Anchored pirates in time?
Check, 200 years ago.
Everything checks out.
Move language back in time.
It says, land ho ye landlubbers.
Land ho, ye landlubbers! Hey! Wow, six sloops and a frigate from here to the Tortugas.
Ha ha ha, me little pretties. You know, words are very important when you're telling a story. Why, I, Captain Fledibus McNall, the greatest storyteller what ever sailed the seven seas, is here to tell you that it's not just the words that make a tale come alive. It's the way you use them.
I don't get it.
Shiver me timbers, laddie. It's the power of the words that I'm talking about. Now, you listen here. Suppose I spies a scurvy pirate ship out there in the distance. I turns to you and I says,
"Look, there's pirates over there."
No, that doesn't go with the way you look.
And then I says,
"The pirates are approaching. Attention, the pirates are approaching."
No way, not even close. Now you sound like a robot.
Ah, now listen again. Avast ye swabs, pirates off the starboard bow!
Wow.
Hi, laddies. It's the power of words. Match your words to the people and the places in your story and watch it come alive!
Where'd he go? Can we go with him?
In our imaginations.
I like to, Figment, but my imagination is stuck. Maybe it's because I really don't know much about pirates.
Maybe it would help if we read about pirates.
What a great idea! If we read about pirates before we make up our own story, we'll know just how they talked and lived.
Look at this, Captain Hook.
Treasure Island, I love this book.
Figgy, it's all here. How they dressed, how they talked, what it all looked like.
Well then, let's just add our imaginations and... Ready, steady, go!
But Figment...
Uh-oh, silly me. Forgot to tell you what to do. Take everything you just learned from books and jiggle it all up. Give it a good shake, then... Let it loose in your mind. Got it?
Think yeah. So.
Then watch closely, listen carefully, see what you can see. With the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can see whatever you want to see.
I see it. I see it. A ship.
A really tall ship with lots of sails.
It's sailing over the ocean.
What color is the ocean? How big are the waves?
It's a dark blue ocean with big waves. The sky is full of clouds and there's a strong wind. I can see it clearly now. It's bound for Pirate Island to search for treasure.
Whee! Let's go! Travel there in your mind.
Now I can see the beach at the island. I'm there. But where's Nick? Come on, Nick, imagine.
Okay. I did it, Figgy. I did it.
Isn't the imagination wonderful? Now, use the power in your mind to make up a super de-looper story.
Okay. I can do it. It was about 200 years ago, and we were looking for hidden treasure.
That's great. 3 years had passed since Nick and I found a bottle washed up on the beach. Inside was a mysterious treasure map.
Yeah, we'd been having nothing but bad luck, and our supplies were nearly gone.
But our spirits lifted as we followed the map.
200 paces from water's edge, turn yourself so you face the ledge. 3 giant steps and you're almost there. Spy the green rock, then if you dare, go 2 steps beyond and there you be. Birchwood marks the spot. Sincerely, me.
Nick, says I, we'll have to dig. Just then, pirates surprised us. Aye, me little buckaroos, says the meanest looking one. Dig you will now that you've led us to the gold.
We had no choice. We had to dig. Hours passed before we hit the chest.
Sir, says I to the scurviest looking pirate, it's the treasure we found.
Then he turns to me and says, take a good look, laddie. It's the last treasure you'll ever see. Soon you'll be walking the plank.
Figment, help! Tell us what to do.
Just use your imaginations and change the way the story's going.
Okay, Jesse. Let's have Flutterbus come to our rescue.
Yeah, Flutterbus.
Oh, this is exciting.
The meanest looking pirate began to shake. Shiver me timbers. The ghost of Flutterbus.
Aye, so be it, says Flutterbus with a wink. You made me walk the plank, but I've returned to claim what's rightfully mine.
The pirates were so scared they scattered in every direction. I'll hunt you scurvy dogs for the rest of your days.
Then he turned to us and said, aye, me friends, 'tis I in the flesh for sure. Now let's see what this old treasure chest holds. There was gold, silver, and jewels, but Flutterbus was searching for something else.
Aye, says he, here's the real treasure. Tall tales from the high seas, the best stories ever told.
Then we swapped stories long into the night with the greatest storyteller who ever roamed the seven seas.
Wow!
Can't believe that happened.
Look, the book!
How neat.
What do you think, Figment?
Is our story good enough for the contest?
Aye, it's a grand story, grander than grand.
I felt like I was there. I could smell the ocean.
And I could hear the seagulls calling.
It seems so real, I could almost feel the spray of the sea on me face.
Tinkerbell, where are you? Figment?
Peter Pan!
Where am I? Tinkerbell and I were on our way to Wendy's house.
Wendy's house? You're way off course. Of course.
Of course?
Tinkerbell's fairy dust must have blown in my eyes.
You'll help me find Wendy, won't you, Figment? It's not that I need her, but the Lost Boys have been missing her stories, and they asked me to bring her back to Neverland.
The Lost Boys, Well, I'd hate to disappoint them, but Peter, I don't know the way to Wendy's house. But I do have an idea.
Great! Let's do it!
All we have to do is get some directions from a map. Just go over to my book nook and get my orange map book.
Here it is, Figment!
Great! I'll just write down the directions to Wendy's house, and you can be on your way.
Figment, there's something I have to tell you. I can fly!
I know.
I can crow! I'm great with the sword! But I can't read.
Gee, golly, and double gosh. I guess my directions won't help.
Figment, can you do that with Wendy?
Do what?
Move Wendy from one place to another. Then you could just bring her here.
Well, I'll give it a try. What do you think Wendy would be doing right now?
Reading my favorite story. Peter Pan!
Okay, I'll just tune in to anyone reading Peter Pan. Watch. Yell when you see Wendy.
And what had talked and what heard and squawked, he said. Mrs.
answered Michael as they jumped.
Fairies, gnomes, or even Peter Pan.
I'm Peter Pan, and you're Captain.
Thought you would escape, Peter, but you're caught.
I believed in Peter Pan. But that was a
lot. It's Wendy, Figment. Bring her here.
I'll see what I can do. Hi there.
Who are you?
Why, I'm Figment of the imagination. I live in a magical place called Figonia.
What are you doing here?
Peter Pan sent me.
Peter Pan?
The one and only. He's at my place, Figonia, and was hoping you'd come and tell him stories.
Stories? Well, I do love telling stories.
Then come on.
Wow, Figment. Fantastic. Figonia is a wonderful place. But where's Peter Pan? Peter Pan! Peter Pan! Where are you? Peter Pan! Peter Pan!
Here I am, Wendy! Hey, you're not Wendy.
No, my name is Amy, and I'm very glad to meet you. You're one of my favorite characters.
Well, thanks, but you won't do. I couldn't see her face. She sounded like Wendy. But you're not, so you'll have to go back.
That's too bad. I know lots of wonderful stories.
You do?
And I have books filled with zillions of stories.
Come on!
Let's go, Amy! I love stories!
We can read together. What one should we do first?
Besides Peter Pan?
Mm-hmm.
Well, let's see, you go first.
Sleeping Beauty is one of my favorites. After Peter Pan, that is. You know, all those kings and queens, good fairies, and evil spells. Don't you just love the part where the handsome prince finds Sleeping Beauty in the castle and awakens her with a kiss?
Yuck! Can't say that would be my favorite part.
Oh, I know. You probably like the part where the prince fights a dragon. Everyone knows how brave you are! That's probably why you like the Jungle Book.
The what book?
By Rudyard Kipling. You know, Mowgli, the boy who was raised by the wolves, and his friend Baloo, the bear. Don't you remember? They had all those adventures in the jungle.
Never heard of them.
Shere Khan the tiger? I bet you liked it best when you fought with Mowgli. It's incredible how when you read a book, it can make you feel like you're right there.
That's for sure. With the power of words and the magic of books, anything is possible.
Yeah, the magic of books. Of course, I can't read.
Oh, Peter, I forgot.
It's no problem, Amy. You can read to me and the Lost Boys just like Wendy did. How would you like to visit Never Never Land?
Oh, I'd love to, Peter. But only if I'm home by bedtime. This is a school night, you know.
Okay, now here's what you do. Stand here. Wonderful thoughts. And I'll sprinkle you with pixie dust.
Ice cream and roller coasters, snowflakes, cinnamon, acting out stories, reading out loud.
Great, Amy! Let's fly!
Peter, come back! I'm still here! What happened? Why can't I fly?
Amy, come on! What are you waiting for?
Well, I was thinking wonderful thoughts, but I couldn't fly.
Silly me! I should have explained. In the pages of the book Peter Pan, you fly by thinking wonderful thoughts. But here in Figonia, we fly by using our imaginations. Ready to try? Then say the magic words with me. Watch carefully, listen closely. See what you can see. Through the power of words and the magic in your mind, you can be wherever you want to be.
Bye, Figgy. Ooh, I'm flying! This is great!
There it is, Amy! Second star to the right and straight on till morning.
Peter, look! It's Never Never Land! I can see Mermaid's Lagoon and Captain Hook's ship!
And guess where we are now?
This is where you live! Underground with the Lost Boys. You just go through that hole, right?
Welcome to Hangman's Tree. My secret hideout. Great, huh?
Oh, Peter, it's just how I imagined it would be. Peter, the package! Come on, we gotta get out of here! Big man! Thanks, Figgy.
Why did we have to get out of there?
That package was from the pirates.
How did you know?
It says right here on page 75 that you happened to bump into a big package that had been left there intentionally by the pirates.
The pirates? It could have been a bomb.
You mean you didn't know?
How could I know? I'm a character in the book. Story's new to me every time. Do you mean if I could read, I'd know what Hook wants to do before he does it?
Sure, if you read, you have a chance to know what any character is thinking. Like Captain Hook, or Tiger Lily, or even you. Of course, I like Wendy the most.
I'll bet that's because you're both girls. And you like to tell stories just like Wendy does.
Yeah, but it's more than that. Wendy just thinks the way I think. After all, we both believe in Peter Pan!
Well, of course!
Sometimes my friends and I even act out the story. I play Wendy, Scott plays Hook. My friend Jennifer plays you. You should see her.
She walks around the room like this.
Boy, that sounds like fun.
Yeah, you should see the adventures we have with books.
Really?
Sure. We can go anytime we want, anywhere we want.
When I read, I'd like to visit olden times. Dragons were very popular then, you know.
Could we go back to that jungle? The one with Mowgli and his friends?
Sure. It's as easy as opening a book.
I like the part about the elephants.
Elephants? Who wants to see elephants? I want to meet Shere Khan, the fierce tiger. I'm not afraid of Shere Khan. Come on, Amy, read to me about him.
Okay, here it is. Mowgli was very scared, but he tried not to show it. So here he was, with his worst enemy and no one to help him.
I know just how he feels.
Mowgli gathered up his courage and said, "I'm not afraid of you."
That's what I'd say. Wow, this is great.
That's the magic of books.
Shh, Shere Khan will hear you.
I'm not afraid. Come on, tiger.
Ooh, this is exciting.
You must be afraid of me, said Shere Khan. Everyone is afraid of me. Well, I'm not, said Mowgli.
I wasn't scared, not for a second. In fact, I'm ready for another adventure. How about reading a book that happens on the moon?
Oh, I'd love to, Peter, but I have to go home.
But Amy...
Don't worry, Peter. You can keep having adventures. Lots of them.
But how?
By opening a book. If you learn to read, every time you read a story, you can be someone else. You can go somewhere else. You can do anything you want.
It's magic. Magic of the mind. The kind that lets you go anywhere, anytime.
Well, I certainly like magic. And going on adventures. Learn to read. I'll have to think about that.
Figgy, now I need some magic. I have to get home. Bye, Peter. I'm really going to miss you.
Amy, don't you remember? Just open Peter Pan, and I'll be there.
Watch this, Wendy. Peter jumped up in the air and landed on Captain Hook's boat. Then Hook saw him. He was overcome with rain, and Hook was sorted out. But Peter was so fast that he jumped on the ledge and bounced out.
Hi, Andy.
Who are you? What happened to Alice?
Why, I'm Figment of the Imagination. I live in a magical place called Fogonia. Alice made a wrong turn in Wonderland and ended up at my place. Now, I need help getting her back. You know all about Wonderland, don't you?
Yeah.
Then, come on!
Wow, Figment! This place is neat!
Why, thanks! It's a special place I dreamed up, full of magic.
Alice in Wonderland! You're here! Why, yes, I am. Curious. And curious, isn't it? You see, I was walking through the woods in Wonderland, trying to find my way out. I turned to the right, and suddenly, I'm here.
Wow!
Have you any ideas on how he can get back?
Well, I read a book once called The Wizard of Oz, where a little girl named Dorothy got back home by clicking her heels 3 times and saying, "There's no place like home."
My goodness. Well, all right, here I go. There's no place like Wonderland. There's no place like Wonderland. Oh no, I'm still here.
Guess you need ruby slippers.
Why not stay in Fogonia? We could have terrific fun.
Oh, thank you for the invitation, Figment. But I do so miss Wonderland. And think of how sad the children would be if they opened my book and I wasn't there.
That's for sure. Alice in Wonderland is one of my very favorite stories.
Why, thank you, Andy. But I really shouldn't be taking the credit. A man named Lewis Carroll made up all my adventures in Wonderland.
Now, there's someone with a wonderful imagination. Maybe he left some clues behind on how to get you back to Wonderland.
Yeah! Maybe if we look in your book, Alice, we'll find some clues on how to get you back there again.
Oh, how sad. I'm no longer in my own book.
Don't worry, Alice. We'll have you back in the picture in no time.
Listen to this. Suddenly, a white rabbit with pink eyes ran by quite close to her. That's you, Alice. She's never seen anything quite like it. The rabbit actually wore a waistcoat and a red jacket.
That's how my adventure started. I saw the white rabbit, and I just had to know where he was going.
So the white rabbit knows how to get to Wonderland?
Well, yes, I suppose he does. But how does that help us?
It means that if we could just talk to the white rabbit, we can ask him how to get you back there again.
But that's impossible, because the white rabbit's in Wonderland, and I'm here.
Don't worry, Alice. Figment, can't you do something, like get him on the phone?
Telephone? I can do better than that. Watch. White rabbit, white rabbit, we need your help.
Okay, okay.
It's him.
3 steps. Yes, 3 steps to follow.
Wait, please. Oh, dear. He's gone.
Wait, there's more.
Look,
it's Tweedledee and Tweedledum.
Perhaps we better avoid them. They probably just want to take up my time with more nonsense stories.
If you want to know what the rabbit said, you ought to speak to us.
You saw the white rabbit?
Yes, he said, follow 3 steps back to Wonderland. Right, the 3 steps of writing a story.
Write a story that gets me back to Wonderland? But how? What's the first step?
Just brainstorm, that's the way to start. Brainstorm with all your might. Just do your very best to let your thoughts go left and right. And then ideas will come to you different as day and night.
I guess it's time to brainstorm.
My goodness!
Boy, I guess brainstorming is pretty magical.
Magical? That gives me an idea. Let's make up a story about the olden days with the magical wizard.
Wow!
Yeah, and a dragon.
Oh, I just adore Once Upon a Time stories. How about having a king? Evil spells. A castle. All in a faraway land.
Pickles.
Pickles?
Pickles.
Tweedledee and Tweedledum said to let our imaginations run wild.
Well, we've certainly done that. What's the next step?
Maybe we should try to find the white rabbit again.
The white rabbit! Look! There he...
Oh, my goodness! I'm late!
Now we'll never find out what goes into a story after brainstorming.
I talked to the rabbit! He told me what you need to do!
It's the Mad Hatter at his tea party!
Of course! You just put your thoughts together and, pardon me. And you start to write a story of some kind!
Okay, we have to put our thoughts together to make up a story that gets you back to Wonderland. Come on!
Once upon a time, in a faraway land, there was a kind king named, Andrew.
Fantastic! Now your turn. How about an adventurous knight named Alice? The bravest knight in all the land.
Now, if we only had a castle.
Hey! No problem. Follow me.
No offense, Figgy, but this doesn't look like it.
Wow, my goodness.
Now, where were we? I'll write the story down. Oh, yes. There was a kind king named Andrew and an adventurous knight named Alice.
And a wizard named Bob.
Oh, Andy. Wizard Bob is a wonderful character.
Now we need a problem to solve. That's what happens in all good stories.
How about if there was an evil spell on the kingdom that made Wizard Bob forget his magic?
But if I, the bravest knight in all the land, can find a way to undo the evil spell, then Wizard Bob will get his magic back.
Wizard Bob! Wizard Bob! Then you can send Alice back to Wonderland, right, Wizard Bob?
Well, yes, I suppose. What's my name?
This could be a problem. Just a sec. How will we ever break the evil spell?
Come, Your Majesty. Perhaps we need to brainstorm a little more.
Great idea! That should put our story back on track.
I do hope we come up with something. Or I'll never get back to Wonderland.
Maybe Wizard Bob could eat a magic pickle.
A magic pickle?
Well, you can't use every idea in a story.
Maybe we can go slay a dragon.
Slay a dragon? Some dragons are nice.
Terribly sorry, Figment.
All right, let's make the dragon in our story wise. So wise, he knows how to undo the evil spell. But this wise dragon lives far, far away. We have to travel across seas, battle freezing blizzards, until finally we climb a tall, tall mountain where the wise dragon lives.
Oh, wise dragon, sir, how can we break the evil spell and give the magic back to Wizard Bob?
Hee hee, it's me!
evil spells, restoring magic. Aha, here we have it. Wizard Bob must turn around 3 times, hop on his right foot, and say, slickety, lickety, farlop, and dippity.
To bring the dragon's answer back to the kingdom, we braved thunderstorms, walked across deserts, and made our way through raging snowstorms.
Figment, we're back! Wizard Bob, Wizard Bob!
You made it! Yippee!
Wizard Bob! I know how to undo the evil spell! You just turn 3 times, hop on your right foot, and say, slickety, lickety, farlip, and dippity.
On to. Slippity lickety, farlip and dippity. Back to Wonderland.
What?
Oh no. Now I shall never get back to Wonderland. I wonder what's wrong.
Hey, maybe the magic didn't work because we haven't done the 3rd step.
What was that? The White Rabbit.
What will I do?
Maybe he knows the 3rd step.
White Rabbit, we did what you told us. We brainstormed, we wrote. What's wrong?
Yes, 1 more step to go. Let's see, the story is good. You have to, rewrite. Oh, my goodness.
Rewrite? What does that mean?
Oh, I think that's very good advice. It means we should take another look at our story and see what we can add or take out. That will make it wonderful. Come on.
I think it would be good to know who's behind the evil spell.
Let's say it was a terrible witch. Let's see. The witch stole Wizard Bob's Book of Magic Spells.
Great.
Ooh, this is making our story really magical.
But how will we get the book back?
I've got it. Let's say she was chased from the kingdom by a magical thunderstorm sent by the forces of good.
Oh, yes. She was in such a hurry. She left the Book of Magic Spells behind, and now we've got it back. That finishes our rewrite.
All 3 steps are done.
Now, I bet our story's magical enough to send you back to Wonderland.
Wonderland! Getting back to... Here it is!
This has to be it. Bye, Figment. Bye, Andy.
Brainstorm, write, and rewrite. Build a story. And return a wizard's magic in all its glory. But the best kind of magic in the story at hand is getting Alice back to Wonderland.
She's back!
one little spark of inspiration is at the heart of all creation. Right at the start of everything that's new, one little spark lights up for you. Oh, hello there. So glad you could come along. I am the Dreamfinder. Musical notes. What delightful melodies those will make. I love these flights of fancy, searching the universe for sounds, colors, ideas, anything that sparks the imagination. A sunbeam. That's a good one. Oh, everything I collect can inspire amazing and marvelous new ideas. And you never know what kind of figment you may come up with. Oh, here's my favorite. Two tiny wings, eyes big and yellow, horns of a steer, but a lovable fellow. From head to tail, he's royal purple pigment, and there, voila! You got a figment of imagination.
Dreamfinder, I'm just right.
Not quite.
Huh?
I'll throw in a dash of childish delight. Look, Figment, some new friends have joined us.
Can they imagine too?
Of course. Imagination is something that belongs to all of us.
You mean everyone can think up new things.
That's right, Figment. And every sparkling idea can lead to even more. So many times, we're stumbling in the dark, and then, eureka! What a spark!
How are we going to use lightning?
We can combine it with ghostly shivers on a stormy night and turn them into a tale of fright.
Look, a rainbow. I'll use that. You paint with.
Now you've got it.
Wow. Numbers, letters, papers for writing, costumes, makeup, stages for lighting, tears of laughter.
What about science?
Science? We'll need electron beams and crystal prisms, gyroscopes and magnetism, holy grail.
Hold on, Figment.
Why?
The idea bag is full.
It is? Let's start making new things.
No, wait. First, we must store these ideas with the others in the dream port.
Are we almost there?
Oh, the dream port is never far away when you use your imagination.
Come on, everybody. Let's go.
We all have sparks. Imagination.
Yeah.
That's how our minds create creations. Right at the start of everything that's new, one little spark lights up for you.
Oh, boy.
Imagination. Imagination. A dream can be a dream come true with just that spark. In me and you.
Is at the heart
of all creation, right at the start of everything that's new. One little spark lights up for you. Imagination, imagination. A dream can be a dream come true.